Oh, I'm Brian Briski. I work for NRCS out of the Altoona area office. Out here today doing some cover crop evaluations. What we're going to be looking at is just kind of some physical differences. What we got going on here actually is we got a couple different treatments. This treatment over here is a continuous, on my right, is a continuous corn silage without a cover. Over here is continuous corn silage with a cover. Just a couple things before I even start digging at, I kind of look at as I look at the soil surface here. Again, it's very smooth. I can see from the spring rains. We probably had some little bit of sheet movement here. This thing wasn't armored. I do see a few spots where we had some worms present. Over on this side, I have rye. It's about 6 inches tall. We're picking up definitely, I would say visually, a higher worm activity. You got a mint in here, one here, one here, one here, one over here. So again, I see a couple different differences there. Next thing what I'm gonna do is it's fork season. So I wanna empower anybody that has a fork in the garden shed. It's not quite potato season yet. Let's get out here, do some digging. So I'm gonna dig into this ground here. And I'm gonna call this, I call it the pop test. We're gonna pop it, see what we got here. You notice this comes out in one big kind of clump here. On this side, I'm gonna go in here and our row of cereal rye. Got our little Velcro rip going on there. And I'm gonna bring that over here. Now the thing that's interesting about this is we notice how easily this just shatters apart, and we got what I call a really tilty or granular structure here. This is something that I wanna really be trying to plant my corn into. On this side here, again, I can see I have my big crust layer, probably a weaker aggregate here where it got smashed down. This thing here, just it doesn't break apart as good as this. As we can see, this power of this rye root has definitely created a different environment for us. So with that being said, I just wanna just reiterate here with the rye. It's not necessarily what's going on top. It's also what's going on underneath.